Hey, it's Christine with another 1 minute book recommendation, and today I want to talk about a book called Da Vinci's Tiger, written by L.M. Elliott, published in 2015. This is a very well-written, well-researched historical novel that is intended for teens, but I'm recommending it for adults also. It kind of reminds me of The Girl with the Pearl Earring book. The setting is Renaissance Italy. And the author weaves her own version of history. She has some historical characters and then some that are fictional. So we have Ginevra de Benci, Leonardo da Vinci, Bernardo Bembo, and Lorenzo de Medici. So they're living the life of the Florentine elite, where the clothes are very glamorous and excessive and the parties are frequent. So we find Ginevra is in an arranged marriage with a local merchant and not very happy about it. She's young, he's older, but she catches the eye of this Venetian ambassador, Bernardo Bembo, and he wants her to become his platonic muse. So apparently it's a cultural tradition in that time that like well-to-do men would find a young, beautiful woman for a purely platonic relationship. And they felt that these women would inspire honor and morals and virtue. And by spending time with them, they would absorb that. So Ginevra accepts his offer of being his muse, and he introduces her to Leonardo da Vinci. And so they start to have sessions. He wants her portrait painted. So they start to have sessions, and da Vinci encourages her independence and intelligence. And on the other hand, she encourages his use of new art techniques that he's well known for now. This is kind of a feminist novel. Ginevra is very well aware of the limitations of being female, but by being this muse, she spends more time in high society and finds out how decisions are made and how she can influence some of the decisions that are being made. At times, I question whether this girl in Renaissance Italy would think of some of the inequalities in the way that she did. It has a more modern feel in that way. I don't know. I wasn't there, obviously. So I don't know if women would think the same way that we do today. But it is inspiring, especially for young women. It's not a romance novel. There is no romance in this. I would classify it more as a historic feminine novel, but very well written. Quick read, very compelling, so I hope you pick up Da Vinci's Tiger.